भगवान श्री आदि शंकराचार्य विरचित श्री शिवापराध क्षमापन स्तोत्रम। आदौ कर्म प्रसंगात् कलयति कलुषम् मातृकुक्षौ स्थितं माम् विण्मुत्रा मेद्य मध्ये कथयति नितराम् जाठरो जातवेदाः यद्यद्वै तत्र दुःखं व्यथयति नितराम् शक्यते केन वक्तुं क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। बाल्ये दुःखातिरेको मललुलितवपुस्तन्यपाने पिपासा नोशक्तश्चेन्द्रियेभ्यो भवगुणजनिता जन्तवो मां तुदन्ती। नानारोगादिदुःखात् हृदनपरवशः शङ्करं न स्मरामि क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। प्रौढोऽहं यौवनस्थो विषयविषधरैः पञ्चभिर्मर्मसन्धौ दष्टो नष्टो विवेकः सुतधनयुवतिस्वादसौख्ये निषण्णः शैवी चिन्ताविहीनं मम हृदयमहो मानगर्वाधिरूढं क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। वार्धक्ये चेन्द्रियाणां विगतगतिमतिश्चाधिदैवादितापैः पापैर्रोगैर्वियोगैस्त्वनवसितवपुत्प्रौढिहीनं च दीनम् मिथ्यामोहाभिलाषैर्भ्रमति मम मनो धूर्जटेर्ध्यानशून्यं क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। नो शक्यं स्मार्तकर्म प्रतिपदगहन प्रत्यवायाकुलाख्यं श्रौते वार्ता कथं मे द्विजकुलविहिते ब्रह्ममार्गे सुसारे। नास्था धर्मे विचारः श्रवणमननयोः किं निदिध्यासितव्यं क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। स्नात्वा प्रत्यूषकाले स्वपनविधिविधौ नाकृतं गाङ्गतोऽयं पूजार्थं वा कदाचित् बहुतरगहनात् खण्डबिल्वीदलानि। नानीता पद्ममाला सरसि विकसिता गन्धपुष्पे त्वदर्थं क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। दुग्धैर्मध्वाज्ययुक्तैर्दधिसितसहितैः स्नापितं नैव लिङ्गं नोलिप्तं चन्दनाद्यैः कनकविरचितैः पूजितं न प्रसूनैः धूपैः कर्पूरदीपैर्विविधरसयुतैर्नैव भक्षोपहारैः क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। ध्यात्वा चित्ते शिवाख्यं प्रचुरतर्धनं नैव दत्तं द्विजेभ्यो हव्यं ते लक्षसङ्ख्यैर्हूतवह वदने नार्पितं बीजमन्त्रैः। नोतप्तं गाङ्गतीरे व्रतजपनियमैरुद्रजाप्यैर्न वेदैः क्षन्तव्यो मे पराधः शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। स्थित्वा स्थाने सरोजे प्रणवमयमरुत्कुण्डले सूक्ष्ममार्गे शान्ते स्वान्ते प्रलीने प्रकटितविभवे ज्योतिरूपे पराख्ये लिङ्गज्ञे ब्रह्मवाक्ये सकलतनुगतं शङ्करं न स्मरामि क्षन्तव्यो मे पराध शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। नग्नो निस्संग शुद्ध त्रिगुण विरहितो ध्वस्त मोहांधकारो नासाग्रे न्यस्त दृष्टिर्विदित भवगुणो नैव दृष्टः कदाचिद् उन्मन्यावस्थया त्वां विगत कलिवलं शंकरं न स्मरामि क्षन्तव्यो मे पराध शिव 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 भोः श्री महादेव शंभो। चंद्रोद्भासित शेखरे स्मरहरे गंगाधरे शंकरे सर्पैर्भूषित कंठकर्ण विवरे नेत्रोत्थ वैश्वानरे दंतित्वकृत सुंदरां वरधरे त्रैलोक्य सारे हरे मोक्षार्थं कुरु चित्त वृत्तिमखिलां अन्यैस्तु किं कर्मभिः। किं वानेन धनेन वाजिकरिभिः प्राप्तेन राज्येन किं वा पुत्रकलत्र मित्रपशुभिर्देहेन गेहेन किम् ज्ञात्वै तत्क्षणभङ्गुरं सपदिरे त्याज्यं मनो दूरतः स्वात्मार्थं गुरुवाक्यतो भज भज श्रीपार्वतीवल्लभम्। आयुर्नश्यति पश्यतां प्रतिदिनं व्यातिक्षयं यौवनं प्रत्यायान्ति गताः पुनर्न दिवसाः कालो जगद्भक्षकः। लक्ष्मीस्तोयतरङ्गभङ्गचपला विद्युच्चलं जीवितं तस्मान्मां शरणागतं शरणद त्वं रक्ष रक्षाधुना। करचरणकृतं वा कायजं कर्मजं वा श्रवणनयनजं वा मानसं वा अपराधम् विहितमविहितं वा सर्वमेतत् क्षमस्व। जय जय करुणाब्धे श्री महादेव शंभो। जय जय करुणाब्धे श्री महादेव शंभो। जय जय करुणाब्धे श्री महादेव शंभो। हरि ओम। गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम भवानी शंकरौ वंदे श्रद्धा विश्वासरूपिणौ याभ्यां विना न पश्यन्ति सिद्धा स्वान्तस्थमीश्वरं। हरि ओम। वी आर स्टडिंग द श्लोक नंबर 8. वी सॉ द होल मीनिंग. ध्यात्वा चित्ते शिवाख्यम प्रचुरतरधनम नैव दत्तम द्विजेभ्यो हव्यं ते लक्षसंख्यैः हुतवह वदने नार्पितं बीजमंत्रैः नोतप्तं गांगतीरे व्रतजपनियमै रुद्रजाप्यैर्न वेदैः क्षन्तव्यो मे पराध शिव 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 भो श्री महादेव शंभो. भगवान रिमेंबरिंग इन योर माय माइंड I never gave any danam to anyone. I did not perform any Vedic ritual in which we offer the oblations. That's called yajna. Or on the banks of Gangaji, I did not do any kind of penance, observing different kind of vows, japa ityadi. I should have done that, no? Bhagavan says, yeah, you should have done. Bhagavan said, if you had read Bhagavad Gita, you would have known that. Huh? The Bhagavad Gita, or even in the Upanishads and all that also, he said, yajno dhanam tapascheiva pavanani manishinam. These acts of yajna, the sacrifice, danam, charity, or tapa, austerity, they are great means of purification of mind. So the bhakta says, I vaguely remember, I had heard that. But now I remember that, but you know, I did not do it. And it should not be given up. That also it is said. You must do it. Because these are great purifiers of mind. So I did not do the Shodashopachara Murti Puja. Then I did not do even the Shruti Prokta Yajnagadi Dan. Then Bhagavan, I came to know that there is one more path also. They call it Yoga Marga. Yoga. Even though elaborate that is pointed out, of Ashtanga, 8 limbs are there or steps are there. But I did not do that also. That is only here indicated in this 9th shloka. As I mentioned, our Puja Gurudev has not written any commentary on these 2 shlokas, 8 and 9. But I told you some meaning of the shloka 8. Actually, what can I say about yoga marga? Yes, asana, pranayama, we don't do that. We don't know also. As you are reading here, so that also is a marga. Some people are very fond of that. They have got aptitude for that. They have got ability. And most important, guidance from a competent yogi. That is most essential. Actually, any path we follow, a teacher is required. So, but what is said here, we just see it. Sthitva sthane saroje pranavamaya marutkundale sukshma marge shante swante praline prakatita vibhave jyoti rupe parakhe lingadnye brahma vakye Sakala tanugatam shankaram nasmarami kshantavyo me paradaha shiva 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 bho shri mahadeva shambho. Bhagavan, this yoga marga also there. here only the essence of it is pointed out. Sthitva sthane shankaram na smarami. That is the main sentence actually. Sthitva, staying. Then we say, no, ekante sukhamasyatam. For meditation, you should go to a solitary place in solitude. And a place should be most inspiring one. Or even in your own house also, if you are sitting, the place should be clean, neat. The atmosphere should be such that your mind feels elevated. So, yes, sthitva sthane, sthane ekanta sthane, sitting there, I do not do this. And what is that? And what you have to do ekanta sthane? The meditation which is pointed out in the yoga mark, through the pranayam. So what they say, that there is a great power, shakti. They are called kundalini shakti. And it is to be raised from here down up to here, and here the crown of the head, sahasrar it is called. So they say by that, here sahasradala kamala, that is called saroje. Saroje means kamala. Not Saroj, which is there in the lake, huh? There, here, how they raise and all that, please don't ask me, I do not know. Through this pranayam practice from a great teacher, the pranas are taken upward. So called pranavaya marut kundale. Marut means vayu only. So when the pranavayu is taken to the crown of the head, it is raised. Pranava swarupa it is, omkara, and sukshma marga, it is very, very subtle. So in the yoga marga, all the descriptions are there. But as far as we, in our Chinmay Mission, our main path is Vedanta Vichar, right? So we do this Vedanta Vichar, but here in this path, when the prana shakti is raised to this here, called sahasradala kamala, sahasrardha, there it is raised, which is very subtle marga, sukshma marga, and there shante, swante. It is swante means in you only, it's not outside somewhere. And there in the shanta, because there is no distraction, no disturbance, nothing. And the yogi is becoming one with that reality there. Praline, when all thoughts, everything is now completely dissolved. Prakatita vibhave, and there all the spiritual glory, that which becomes manifest, spiritual teja, Jyoti Rupa is called Jyoti Swarupa. The Jyoti is not outside Jyoti. In the Upanishad and Gita, I say Jyoti Sham Apitad Jyoti Tamasa Paramuchyate. This Jyoti, this light of consciousness, is beyond darkness, light. That Chaitanya is called Parakhe. Akhe means it's known as Para, the Supreme. The idea is, see, in our marg, what we say generally, in our heart, we meditate. And this Chaitanya Swarup, that which is there, here we experience. In the Yoga Marg Shastra, it is pointed out in this way, when that Shakti is raised, and the pranas become one here at that time, and there all the splendor of spiritual experience, that which comes there, prakatita vibhava, what it is? Lingadne. Lingadne means it cannot be spoken by words. And it is not the meaning of एनी लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ एनी वर्ड. लिंगत ने मीन्स वॉट इंडिकेटिव इट इज. इट कैन बी इंडिकेटेड बाय दैट लैंग्वेज विच इज कॉल्ड द लैंग्वेज इम्प्लीकेशंस, नॉट लिटरल मीनिंग. ब्रह्मवाक्ये the statements that are made by the Upanishads, then you realize that Swarupa, it is a Pranavamaya. In the Upanishad, he said, Sarve Veda Yat Padamamananti. All words of the Upanishad, they indicate that absolute reality by the word Om. There this Jyoti is nothing but the Shankar Bhagwan. He is Nirguna, Niraka, Nirvishesh, Chaitanya Swarupa. Sakala Tanugatam. This Chaitanya Jyoti is present in all bodies. Sakala all, Tanu means body, because it's the Antaryami, Sarvantaryami. And that Tattva is Shankara Bhagavan. Sham Karoti, that which brings all auspiciousness, that Shankara Bhagavan I did not remember. So now idea is what? In short, O Lord, I did not remember you, did not meditate on you by any method, that through Murti Puja or through Yajna Yagadis or through this Yoga Marga. There are all the descriptions are also there, teachers are also there, ready to guide, but I did not take interest in any one of them. At least something should have done. Kuch nahi kya. Na puja, na japa, na tapa, na dana, na yajna, na dhyanam. Sitting ekanta sthan, by the practice of pranayama, raising my all that consciousness up. And there the Chaitanya Swarup, Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram, that Paramatma Tattva which is there, I did not think of that. So idea is, even though so many paths, so many sadhanas are there available, but I did not do any one of them. Kshantavyo me paradhaha Shiva 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 Bhoho Sri Mahadeva Shambho. Bhagavan, please forgive me. Now one more. Asha, all right, you did not do this asana, pranayam, this, that, okay? Yeah. But you could, my beautiful saguna sakar form also is there, you know. That form you could have meditated upon. What is that form of the Lord? Now it is said, now let us see here. The first word itself is rather strange when we read it. What is this? Nagno nissanga shuddhas triguna virahito dvastva mohandakaro nasagre nyasta drishti vidita bhava guno naiva drishta kadachit unmanyavasthaya tvam vigata kalimalam Shankaram nasmarami kshantavyo me paradhaha Shiva 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 Bho Sri Mahadeva Shambho. But again, Shankaram nasmarami, I do not remember, or I did not remember this Lord Shiva. Who is Steve? Through Yajna Yagadi, I did not. Or through this Yoga Marga, I did not. what a Bhagwan's one form, the best form which is there in our Jagdishwar temple. What it describes, Bhagwan says, Nagnaha, the literal meaning of Nagna is naked. Naked? Yeah. Sometimes called Digambara. Sometimes called Chidambara. All the directions are his clothes. Or the Chaitanya is only his clothes. Nagna. The Nagna word is very beautiful word. Because Bhagwan himself expressed that further. Nagno nissanga shuddha triguna rahitaha. That Nagna, the commentary is that. We'll see the commentary. But you just see little babies. Even if they become 1 year, 2 year old also, they naked, they roam about or not. Do they feel anything? Because so pure. They have no idea of that. And you know, if you see the baby and all that, you also don't feel anything. Later on only, shame, shame, shame. And then we are starting telling, you know, that child, go here, there. So one meaning of Nagna is not wearing clothes, right? Why should he is all pervading? All the directions are only his clothes. His Chaitanya Swarupa only. I call Nissanga, no attachment to anything, Shuddha. One and other meaning is that little child does not have any such kind of body identification, ahankara or that, or I am not wearing clothes or this or that, and nothing. Mind is so pure. So, hey, Nissanga. Free from all attachments and identification with the body. Nissang, Shuddha, purity itself. Only when second person comes, so we suddenly feel, hey, otherwise what? So his Advaita Swarupa, Advaita, non-dual Bhagavan, Nissang, Shuddha, Triguna Virahita, totally free from the effects of the Trigunas of that Maya Prakriti called Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, Tamo Guna. They have no bearing on him. That we call Naganaha. He is extremely pure, free from body consciousness, body identification, body attachment, purity only. Tamoguna is that what it covers the reality. Rajoguna creates another the wrong notions there. Then Sattvaguna, if it is mixed with both of them, it also creates problem. They have to go and discriminate, or hey, this is right, wrong, and all that. But here, nothing. Bhagavan Chaitanya Swarupa is ever, ever shining only. So there is no question of veiling, or there is no question of some wrong notion projection, or anything like that. Therefore, Triguna Virahitaha, Nagno Nistranga, Nissanga Shuddha Triguna Virahito, Dhvastva Mohandakaraha. And the Lord Shiva is one, Dhvastha. He has blasted completely. What? Moha Andakara, dispelled. The darkness of Moha, ignorance, wailing and all that. That means Bhagwan is Shuddha Jnana Swarupaha. And the Dhvasta Mohandaka is a very nice phrase, because if we worship him, he will also destroy all our darkness of this delusion. Moha has got me ignorance, lack of discrimination, or the infatuation with the world of objects and all that. Finished. See, the one who is free from this alone can help the other person to be free from that. We ourselves, we are only in that, then the blind leading the blind. Could you drown ho rahe hain? I don't know how to swim. I don't know. And I don't know. And then if I am just standing on the bank of a river and some other person is down and he says, save me, and I try to go and save him. If he had any chance of survival, that will go of him. I don't know what I will do, and then drown him further only. Dhvasta nashta mohandakara. Bhagavan is free from all that. So now all these words are only pointing out his total purity, no body consciousness, identity and attachment, nothing. That is Lord Shiva. Da Shankaram Nasmarami. I live in the company of all those people who are totally mohit only, completely deluded and all that, and then I remain in their company and get more deluded, even more than them. And that Bhagavan Shiva, this is one Swarupa is pointed out, but also this Saguna Sakar Roop, how Bhagavan is Nasagre Nyasta Drishtihi Vidita Bhavagunaha. See, Bhagavan is meditation way. How his eyes are not fully closed, not open like that also. Then, Ardha Unmilitam. Looking at the tip of the nose, called Nasagre Nyasta Drishti. When we'll study also the yoga of meditation and all that, also the word will be there. So that means what? It's a very beautiful thing. For common sadhakas, what it means is, remain focused. Don't go on seeing here, there, everywhere. And when we sit in meditation, say some cut. What happened? Cut. Only Nyasagra Drishti. But in case of Bhagavan Shiva, what is meant is half only closed, or you call half open, whichever you call it. That means what? Even the half is open, he looks at the world from the inner vision. That is the meaning of that. In the Upanishad and Shankaracharya also written place, Drishtim jnanamayim krutva pashyet brahmamayam jagat. You divinize your vision that all this is Brahman only, and then look at this world. So, nasagre drishti, nyasta drishti, one common meaning is what? Means not looking here, there, anywhere, you know. You're fully attentive. Other meaning is, either you say they're half closed or you say half open. Means what? Fully aware of his own inner swarupa, and then just looks at this world. Then the world cannot be binding us. Vidita bhava gunaha. The Bhagavan is one to whom all gunas of this bhava, samsara, everything is known. Vidita means known. Bhava, all the of samsara, gunas, all qualities, virtues, properties, whatever happening here, there, everything he knows. Sarvajnay. But Bhagavan, naiva drishta kadachit. I never saw such a beautiful form. If you look at our Lord Jagdishwara here, he's like this, Nasagre Nyasta Drishti. Such a so sweet smile on the lips. Ananda. Unmanya vasthaya tvam vigata kalimalam shankaram nasmarami. Vigata kalimalam. Bhagavan's your swarupa is what? Vigata, gone, totally free from all the impurities of Kali. All tamogun pradhan, this Kali Yuga, everything is free. And your avastha is unmani avastha, that mind which is transcended. And I also have to do this Unmani Avastha, you know. If I go on meditating on this beautiful form of the Lord, who is Saguna Roop, Nirguna Roop, Sakar Roop, Nirakar Roop, Savishesh, Nirvishe, Unmani Avasthaya, raising my mind to that state of no mind. And I did not see you. Kshantavyo me paradha, Shiva 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 Bhoho, Sri Mahadeva Shambho. So up till now, what we saw, the 10 shlokas, this one line was common. Bhagwan, I was ignorant, committed many mistakes. Earlier, I was not even aware of them. But now when I become aware, I feel what kind of life I live. But now, please forgive me. I want to write a new chapter in the book of my life. Forget the past now. Start. That is following the shlokas are like that only. Kshantavya aparadha is over. So Bhagavan says, yes, yes, forgive. Chalo. Enough of that. Forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. How long will you forgive? How long will you go on saying again and again? Forget. So now Bhagavan is telling his own mind. That means it's a guidance to our mind that up till now whatever happened, happened. Now, hereafter, just think of the Lord. That is the meaning. Those are beautiful shlokas that we'll see now, tomorrow. Now here, not asking for forgiveness, but training the mind. Oh mind, enough of this, all that. Now do.
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya.
Hara Hara Nama Parvati Pataye, Hara Hara Mahadev. श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।